DARPA and Doomsday. This is an interesting article from naturalnews.com. And I think this could play into the end times, to Bible prophecy, where it speaks of pestilences coming upon the earth. And maybe some of the wrath of God is really driven by man's own stupidity and man causing his own trouble. So DARPA developing genetic doomsday weapon to exterminate populations on demand. GMOs to become weapons of mass destruction. U.S. military agency known as DARPA, Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, is investing $100 million in so-called genetic extinction technology. Now, this is scary. If you're adding the gene code so you can cause populations of people, this is called ethnic cleansing, basically, to cause populations of people to die via their genes. This is incredible, and I think this is a red line for God, to be honest. When you start manipulating gene codes where people can't even live anymore, I don't think this is going to go very far, and this is why I think also that the time is very short. Emails acquired under the Freedom of Information Act suggest that the U.S. Secret of Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency has become the world's largest funder of gene drive research. The use of genetic extinction technologies as bioweapons is the stuff of nightmares. The disclosure is this genetic extinction technology comes on the heels of Natural News blowing the whistle on global eugenics program to target and exterminate people of African descent as part of an ongoing global depopulation agenda. Now, I have a video coming out about who is the Illuminati and basically why should we be concerned and do they win? And so you should check out that one. That's going to be being posted this week. In a one-hour video lecture published a few weeks ago, I detailed six vectors through which weaponization of science and medicine is being deployed right now to exterminate blacks. So there's a racism happening. We are all created in the image of God. There is no color, skin color, to God. We are all have just different levels of melanin in the skin. We're all created the same, basically equal. We're equal under God. The genetics doomsday weapon system now being developed by DARPA is based on CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing technique, which allows simple, low-cost laboratories to achieve previously impossible genetic editing goals in almost any organism, including humans. These might, for example, distort the sex ratio of mosquitoes to effectively wipe out malarial populations. They're gonna tinker with it so that you have all males born or all females born, and effectively that means you can't procreate anymore. It's pretty incredible. The dual use nature of altering and eradicating entire populations is as much a threat to peace and food security as it is to the threat to the ecosystem. I think this is how man will destroy the earth, with his tinkering with nuclear meltdowns, with gene editing that will destroy populations because we think we're doing something that's going to help us. Ultimately, we're going to destroy insect populations, which kills the food cycle and the hierarchy of the food cycle. And then man dies from this. It's not for global warming and these sorts of things. This is truly how science is going to kill man if God doesn't have red lines. And I do believe that God is coming soon, because he would put a red line here. He's gonna stop the gene editing. He stopped it in the days of the flood when man was tinkering with the gene code too much, and the fallen angels were tinkering with the gene code. And he's going to come back. I think, like I say, this is a red line. And so that means we have a very short time left before the return of the Lord. I think this is evidence pointing in that direction, that we have maybe a couple of years left before the Lord returns. Well, more specifically, a couple of years before the rapture, and only a couple of years to go before the seven-year tribulation starts. And I think if you look at the Middle East events, they are also lining up and converging to set up this timing that seems to be like the seven-year tribulation is going to start probably around the year 2021. So we'll see if that comes to pass. But all these articles are converging and providing the evidence that all these things are coming together in the world from all different areas and topics, and moving us in a direction that is toward the end time biblically prophetic events in the Bible. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys in the next video.